Now let's explore some reflective questions and examples to help you think critically about integrating EDI considerations at each stage of the research process. The stages of the research process can include, but are not limited to, research questions, design of the study, methodology and data collection, analysis and interpretation, and dissemination of results. Let's start with the research questions. After all, impactful research starts with asking the right questions. Here are a few helpful things to think about. When you are doing the literature review, what keywords could you use in your search to gain a deeper and broader knowledge of who may be impacted by and contributing to the research? What factors and/or intersections of factors are known to affect the research outcomes? What are the knowledge gaps? What assumptions are you making regarding certain variables? Are these based on empirical evidence? Who benefits from or is impacted by the research outcomes and how? What may be the unintended impacts for certain individuals and communities? How are the research questions co-created with, informed by, reflective of, and applicable to the needs or experiences of the communities or various groups with whom you are engaged? Let's look at how applying an inclusive lens to your research questions improves your research. Take the following research question. How does photo cropping impact algorithms on social media? While this is a reasonable approach, a more inclusive question would factor in the different ways people access imagery. The revised question might look like this. How does photo cropping, with or without alternative text, impact algorithms on social media? Alternative text, or alt text, is brief descriptive text that conveys the meaning and context of an image. Assistive technologies like screen readers, for the visually impaired, read alt text. Considering alt text provides detail and depth to the research question. And while this approach may not apply to all research questions or objectives, applying a critical EDI lens to your research questions like this can help you design more inclusive research and, as a result, maximize its impact. As we will continue to see in this video, by proactively addressing constraints and limitations from the beginning of the research process, research can cater to and benefit the experiences of not only one group of users, but of all individuals. Inclusive approaches lead to universal benefits. When you are designing your study, here are some questions to think about to maximize the quality and impact of your research. What equity, diversity, and inclusion-related considerations, variables, or confounders are relevant to your research and need to be integrated to make your research more robust? Why do you consider certain considerations, variables, or confounders, and not others? Who will be conducting the research, and could their social positioning impact the research? And how will that be recognized, acknowledged, and mitigated? How do you identify, reflect on, monitor, address, and mitigate unconscious biases and assumptions? How are you addressing any risks of harm, including risks of inequitable and/or exclusionary treatment? How are any communities of interest, impacted groups, or those with relevant lived experiences informing the design? What protocols and/or best practices are you following to inform your engagement with relevant or impacted communities so that both the community and the researcher benefit? As we saw in the earlier example of the facial recognition systems, designing a study that includes the full diversity of people that will potentially be impacted enhances the relevance and reliability of research results and leads to robust outcomes. Imagine you are researching safety features in a car. Most cars have been designed using crash test dummies based on what is assumed to be a standard adult male model that is scaled for varying heights and weights to account for people of different sizes. But research shows that safety tests using dummies that are more representative of female, pregnant, obese, or elderly bodies greatly improve the effectiveness of the seatbelts in preventing injuries and deaths. Inclusive design, in this case, is a matter of life and death. Designing for diversity considers relevant variables to ensure that findings for one population subset are not overgeneralized, and so outcomes are more robust and reproducible. When you are planning your methodology and data collection, here are a few questions to think about. How do you ensure that there is appropriate or needed representation and diversity in the research participants or datasets? Have you created a data management plan to show how you will manage your data? How will you incorporate EDI considerations throughout that plan? Is your data findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable? What is the best way to collect information on each aspect of diversity relevant to your research? How will you collect information from any human participants, affected groups, and end users? How will you protect their privacy? How is data disaggregated fully and appropriately? What mechanisms are in place to avoid, recognize, and address biases and barriers during data collection? How are you meaningfully engaging impacted groups in the research and applying a participatory research method? What are the different considerations and forms of support needed to remove barriers and ensure their participation? These can include, but are not limited to, financial, logistical, communication, cultural, accessibility, and linguistic considerations. Have you considered how the relations between researchers and research subjects and participants may affect data collection? It is well documented that power imbalances between researchers and their human research participants can profoundly affect research results. But the sex of a researcher can also affect animal research subjects. For example, research on pain experience showed that the presence of male researchers blunted pain behavior of laboratory mice and rats. This was a response that was not observed in the presence of female researchers. This difference was found to be due to stress-induced analgesia caused by the scent of male researchers. A methodology that considers the potential implications of the sex and identities of the researchers leads to more rigorous research. When you are analyzing and interpreting data, here are some questions to consider. What assumptions are you making in the analysis and interpretation, and how could these be checked and mitigated to improve the quality of your research? How are the research participants and groups that are involved in and impacted by your research invited to participate in the interpretation of data and review of findings? How are their needs, insights, and experiences taken into account? How are you including a diversity of perspectives? How are variables, confounders, and their impacts recognized and analyzed? How are you avoiding the overgeneralization of results? How is data disaggregated to recognize the diversity of the population involved or impacted? Have you determined which variables and/or intersections of variables are impacting results? If certain variables are not considered, what is the basis for this decision, and how are limitations to data and analysis indicated and the impacts discussed? If you are working with organisms capable of sex differentiation, are you reporting the sex of the organisms or disaggregating data by sex? Imagine you are a marine biologist studying the effects of ocean acidification on certain animals. Do you think it would be important to note the sex differences of organisms? One literature review found that most analyses of fish, mollusca, crustacea, and echinodermata from 2008 to 2016 did not consider sex differences. But those that did showed that the sex of the organisms significantly modified their response to ocean acidification. Disaggregating experimental results by sex revealed biologically significant differences that would otherwise be masked if data were pooled together. By examining the sex-specific impacts of ocean acidification, researchers are improving the ability to accurately check the resilience of marine populations in different acidic seawaters, which can affect how ecosystems are managed and affect decisions on conservation priorities. Disaggregated data leads to more rigorous analyses and accurate results. A major barrier to the inclusion of sex difference as an experimental variable is the widely held idea that it simply is not relevant nor important to do so. In many instances, this perception stems from the lack of documented sex differences in organisms. Questioning and mitigating norms and assumptions is key to quality research. Sex differences are also important in the analysis of tissues and cells of organisms. Not every experiment needs to be designed to evaluate sex differences, but for every experiment, noting the sex or reasons why the sex is unknown improves the reproducibility of results and avoids unfounded assumptions and generalizations, leading to more rigorous research. Finally, when you are disseminating your results, you could consider questions like, who benefits from and is impacted by the research findings, and how are you collaborating and engaging with them so that they are involved in deciding the best strategies for disseminating and receiving findings? How might these findings empower or disempower certain communities, and how can this be addressed? How can you make sure that your dissemination considers intersectionality and effectively communicates the research relevance and impact to different communities? What are some alternative ways to share research results? How are the results available in open access publication venues? Is the language of dissemination suitable for the impacted communities? In what ways do you consider accessible, inclusive, and plain language when disseminating results? How are you using accessible and inclusive formats and dissemination approaches that would open your research up to different ways of perceiving, understanding, and communicating? Dissemination can take many forms. In the case of the project on facial recognition systems, called Gender Shades, the researchers shared their results on the project's webpage, in interviews, in a video, and a documentary. The affected companies quickly responded to their technology's shortcomings and worked to improve them. As per the Tri-Council Policy Statement on the Ethical Conduct for Research Involving Humans, researchers should ensure that participating individuals, groups, and communities are informed of how to access the results of the research. Results of the research should be made available to them in a culturally appropriate and meaningful format, such as reports in plain language. Inclusive approaches lead to universal benefits and broaden research impact.